una cabeza de un noble potrillo que justo en la raya afloja al llegar y que al regresar parece decir: no olvides, hermano, vos sabes, no hay que jugar. Por una cabeza me tejón de un día de aquella coqueta y risueña mujer.
Most of us are familiar with the beautiful and elegant and passionate dance called the Argentine Tango. We've seen it performed countless times on TV shows such as So You Think You Can Dance and Dancing with the Stars, as well as any number of major motion pictures. Most of you probably know that the dance comes from the South American country of Argentina. There are probably some amongst you who already know that it began around the outskirts of Argentina's capital city, Buenos Aires, sometime in the late 1800s. Those of you who have studied a bit of dance history also probably recognize that the original tango evolved from dances that were not only danced locally, but were brought to Argentina from Europe by its growing immigrant population. But how many of you know that the major original influences on Argentine tango are actually African? If you do not know this, you aren't alone. Think about it for a moment. Of all the images you can recollect from every TV show, motion picture, video clip, or photograph you've ever seen featuring the tango, how many times have you actually seen it danced by a black dancer? Now, I don't say this to suggest that it's a bad thing. Far from it. This is how dances evolve. A dance may begin in one community, but as it grows in popularity, it will take on elements of other communities. We've seen this historically in the United States with dances like the cakewalk, the Charleston, and the Lindy Hop. And we're seeing it even today with the evolution of hip-hop. Our goal here is to simply point out some history that many of you may not be aware of. And so begins my brief history of the black roots of Argentine tango. The Atlantic slave trade, also known as the transatlantic slave trade, refers to the trade in slaves that took place across the Atlantic Ocean from the 16th through the 19th centuries. The vast majority of slaves involved in the Atlantic trade were African from the central and western parts of the continent, who were sold by African slave dealers to European traders who transported them to the colonies in North and South America. There, the slaves were made to labor on coffee, coca, and cotton plantations, in gold and silver mines, in rice fields, the construction industry, timber, and shipping, or in houses to work as servants. More than two-thirds of the slaves who ended up in South America came from the eastern and equatorial region of Africa called Bantu, and a great many of these slaves ended up in the Rio Plata regions of Uruguay and Argentina. There is a single word that has survived through time that fuses all the drum-based black dance and music from that area and era. It is Condombe. These Bantu slaves called their drums tango, and also used this term for the name of the place that they performed the condombe. The dances themselves were also called tangos. During the first half of the 19th century, condombe was a dance typically performed to a group of drummers in large outdoor gatherings of African Argentines who lived mostly in the impoverished barrios in the southern part of the city of Buenos Aires at that time. Candombe represented a fusion of musical and dance traditions from the various parts of Africa from which blacks were brought to that region as slaves. Dancers danced separately with no or occasional minimal contact. It is theorized that the dance we now call tango was born in African Argentine dance venues attended by compandritos, young men, mostly native-born and poor, who liked to dress in slouch hats, loosely tied neckerchiefs, and high-heeled boots with knives tucked into their belts. The compadritos took the tango back to the working-class districts of Buenos Aires and introduced it in various low-life establishments where dancing took place, bars, dance halls, and brothels. It was here that the African rhythms met the Argentine milonga music, a fast-paced polka, and soon new steps began to evolve. Eventually, all of Buenos Aires found out about the tango, and by the beginning of the 20th century, the tango, as both a dance and form of popular music, had established a firm foothold in the fast-expanding city of its birth. It is important to note that the tango danced in Buenos Aires at the beginning of the 20th century is not the tango we see today, not even close. Keñique is the term often used to describe the first dance recognized as tango. Keñique first appeared in the slums at the outskirts of Buenos Aires around the turn of the 20th century and is considered to have lost its popularity by the late 1930s when tango de salón primarily replaced it as the predominant manner of social tango dancing. There are no historical recordings of Keñique dancing, and there has been no one who danced this style in the 1930s who has been able to demonstrate it since the tango renaissance of the mid-1980s. Thus, all that exists to allow reconstruction of the characteristics of Keñique are oral history, some photographs, and vague recollections from childhood of how some adult members of the family danced tango. Nevertheless, despite this, there is a considerable degree of agreement among those attempting to revive this historical tango style as to what characteristics define Keñique. From the 1930s to the present, the Keñique style of tango virtually disappeared, and tango evolved into a dance walked with a straight posture and little vertical movement. This was the predominant stylistic variation of the golden age tango de salón, which mostly is due to the influence of the French and other Europeans after the dance was brought from Argentina to Paris in the early 1900s. However, some movements of candombe transmitted through Keñique survived in the milonga of some dancers, The stumble step characteristic of milonga danced to both primary and secondary accented beats, i.e. milonga contrapice, retained some of the rhythmic play inherited from the culture of African Argentines. There also appeared in some milonga music composed and performed during this period a more emphatic variation in rhythmic characteristics of the drums. The music and movements of African Argentine candombe have been represented in tango, particularly in cañinque, or more specifically, mostly currently in the dance and music of milonga. Nevertheless, there is an evident African Argentine influence upon the evolution of the tango dance and music. The tango is a style of music which resulted from the mixture of several types of music, the habanera, the Spanish fandango, and the milonga. The name tango derives from the word tango, a Bantu term which means drum, and according to the white ethnocentric interpretation, it probably means a meeting or dance of black people. Tango reached its pinnacle of popularity in the 1940s, also known as the Golden Age of Tango, during which it evolved into the form we know today. Now it is considered an integral part of Argentine culture, both in its salon, social, and exhibition theatrical forms. The theatrical form is what you normally see on TV and in movies, while the social or salon form is what is actually danced by most people. Internationally, it is equally popular amongst Hispanic and crossover audiences, with a very large following in many parts of the United States, Europe, Japan, Mexico, and Latin America. And yes, more black people are starting to dance it.
Esta noche me esperan sus ojos en la avenida Centenario.